First of all, my memory's autobiographical, so I'll remember where I was when I read the script, what the character's life reminds me of in my own life, things like that. It's not lines, that's two-dimensional. But I really love kind of holding myself back from lines because I want to know why I'd want to say the lines rather than just saying the lines.
Interesting.
You know, I kind of learned that early on in my career because lines were so easy for me.
I don't want to berate you with the memory thing. Because
okay,
I know you get asked about it all the time.
Oh my gosh, that's all people want to talk
about.
But I just
want to. So but let's just. And also, I'm very envious because that's. I can't remember what I did yesterday.
I know that's what everybody says, that they have a terrible memory. But everybody remembers something especially well. Everybody, it's what I call their primary track. It's like in the jigsaw puzzle of your life. What are the hard-edged pieces? So everyone has some primary track on which they kind of have embedded their memories, and it can be anything from travel to relationships to jobs to food is a huge one.
Huge one, yeah.
My friend Phil Rosenthal, when we've been friends for a long time, and I said to him when I was working on the memory book, I said, "So what's your primary track? Is it everybody loves Raymond scripts?" And he goes, "No, food. I remember every meal I've ever had." And now he's got that show, Somebody Feed Phil.
When does your memory skill come in the most handy? When's the best time you've been able to
getting back at my husband when he thinks something happened, and I'm like, "Don't embarrass yourself. You must be kidding me that you even think that this happened that way. No, don't you remember you were standing in the kitchen with your striped shirt on and I was this and stuff like that." So it's really